the last lecture of this chapter, that is matter around us pure, we had discussed about the centrifugation technique and the separation of two immiscible liquids. Now, today we are having the next separation technique, that is separation of different color from a dye or from black dye. In your NCERT, black dye is given. But this process is used to separate all the colored component present in a specific color. Now, this is for your information that except the primary colors, all colors are made up of several kinds of color. By the mixing of various color, we can make a color. So, how can we separate the different colors present in a specific dye? So, for that, we use a method known as chromatography. This is a very innovative technique to separate the color pigments. Now, here are some history regarding this separation technique. Chromatography. This word is made up of two words actually. First is chroma and other is graphy. Chroma is a Greek word. That's why it starts from K, not C. So, it is a Greek word which means color. And graphy means writing. So, chromatography is the writing of colors. Means what? On the basis of separation of colors, we made this method. That's why it is called as chromatography. Now, this method was discovered by a Russian botanist, Swet. Here it is written. It is discovered by a Russian botanist, Swet, in 1906. Next is, this method is used for the separation of first time actually. It is used for the separation of plant pigments, specifically on a spinach leaves. In class 11, you are having this experiment in your biology, that is separation of different pigments in a spinach leaf. Already you know that other than the chlorophyll, we are having several types of pigment present in the plants. So for the separation of all those pigments, we can use this technique. Now, this technique is most modern and versatile method, and for the separation it is used, and along with that we can use this method for the purification and testing of purity of inorganic and organic compounds. Now there are several types of chromatographic technique or chromatography method like HLC, TLC, GLC, HPLC and paper chromatography. TLC is thin layer chromatography, GLC is gas liquid chromatography, HPLC is high performance liquid chromatography, and the last one is paper chromatography. This is also called as column chromatography. So, the paper chromatography is the most common method for the separation of the colors. In our standard, in class 9, we have to only focus on the last method, that is paper chromatography. So let's have a look on this technique, that is paper chromatography. So let's just have a look on the paper chromatography technique. So the paper chromatography technique is used to separate the different color or pigment present in a specific color. Now, what is the principle behind it? The principle is different solubilities of different components in the same solvent. Since a dye is a mixture of various color, and when we dissolve that color in a solution or in liquid, what will happen? On the basis of different solubilities of the different colored component, we can have the different strips, and we can have the different locations of different color. And on the basis of that, we can separate it. Now, think about the procedure, that how can we perform this experiment, or how can we perform the chromatography. This is also an activity part that is given in your NCERT book. Now, let's just have a look. This is a chromatography paper. This paper is something different from filter paper or normal paper. We can perform this experiment on the filter paper also. If we are not having the chromatography paper, we can perform it on the filter paper. Now, this is a chromatography paper. The first step is we have to make a line on the on this paper. Make a line with the help of pencil and take it approximately 3 cm above the bottom point. Now, the second step is we have to make a dot with any of the ink which we have to separate. If here we have taken the red ink, so we just make a dot of red ink on this chromatography paper. Then we have to hold this. We have to hold this chromatography paper in a beaker containing water. Now you have to keep in mind that this paper is poured in water such that half of the portion of this spot is inside the water and half should be outside the water. So when we keep this on the beaker containing water, after some time we can have different color pattern seen on this paper. So this is actually the method of separating different colors on the basis of the chromatography technique. Here I have kept, because this experiment takes time, so here I have kept the same paper containing the same red ink, and here you can see the different color separation. You can see the pink, yellow and the red one. So if we keep it for a long time, you can see all different colors present in this dye. So this is a very simple technique to perform. You can also perform this in your home. You just have to take a paper. If you are not having the chromatography paper, you can just take the filter paper, make it a strip, then put a pencil mark and then make a dot with the help of the ink. And you just have to pour this and you should keep in mind, then you have to take that much of water in which half of the dot is inside the water and half is outside the water. Then we have to keep it undisturbed. After some time we can see the different color separation on this paper. Now if we want to take this red color, what will we do? We just cut here from here and just keep it in water. After some time, this paper will dissolve and we get the red solution. Then if we want the yellow color, what we will do? We just cut it from here to here and we just keep it in another beaker containing water. This paper dissolves and we get the yellow solution. And for pink, we just have to cut this strip from this point to this point. And we just have to keep it in the another beaker containing water and we get different types of color. So this is the method of chromatography. So by this method we can perform this experiment. Ek simple technique hai. Ek bio mein bhi experiment hai aapka spinach leaf mein color pigment dekhne ka. Karna kya hai usme, jaise agar maan lijiye aap koi green vegetables ka color separate karna chahte hain, uske liye kya karoge? Chromatography paper lena hai. एक लाइन मार्क करोगे, दैट इज अप्रोक्सीमेटली 3 सेंटीमीटर अबव द बॉटम पॉइंट. उसके बाद स्पिनिश लीफ को या फिर कोई भी ग्रीन वेजिटेबल को आप क्रश करोगे विद द हेल्प ऑफ मोटर पेस्टल. यू हैव टू क्रश इट, देन यू गॉट द जूस ऑफ दैट स्पिनिच लीफ. उस जूस का एक ड्रॉप आपको जो लाइन आपने ड्रॉ किया है उसके ऊपर डाल देना है एंड उसको बीकर में इस तरीके से स्टैंड करना है कि आधा जो पॉइंट आपने जो डॉट डाला है, इंक जो डाला है या जो भी कलर डाला है आप सेपरेट होने के लिए, उसका हाफ पार्ट वाटर के अंदर रहे और हाफ पार्ट वाटर के ऊपर रहे. उसको अनडिस्टर्ब्ड आपको उसी तरीके से छोड़ देना है. थोड़े टाइम बाद क्या देखोगे कि अगर उसमें ग्रीन के अलावा कोई और कलर प्रेजेंट है तो आपको डिफरेंट डिफरेंट लेयर्स मिल जाएंगे क्रोमेटोग्राफी पेपर पे. सो दिस इज अ वेरी स्पेसिफिक, वेरी वर्सेटाइल एंड मोस्ट कॉमनली यूज मेथड फॉर नाउ डेज. वी यूज इट वेरी कॉमनली फॉर द कलर सेपरेशन. Now, after this, we are having several applications of the chromatography technique. Other than the separation of color, we are having some more applications of chromatography. Let's have a look. Very first is, it is used to separate colored substances present in dyes and natural pigment, which we had discussed just now. Second is, to monitor the progress of a reaction. So, for monitoring a reaction also, we can have this type of method. We can use this separation technique. Third is to detect and identify drugs present in the blood of criminals in forensic science. So this chromatography technique is also used in forensic science for the detection and identification of drugs present in the blood of criminals. Next one is to separate and identify the amino acids obtained by hydrolysis of protein. Now amino acids are the monomer of protein. So when we hydrolyze the protein, we'll get a monomer amino acids. So to separate that amino acid and to identify that amino acid, we can use this technique. So this is a very important technique, and this will come in your exam definitely. That is the separation of dye from different color. So I just suggest you to perform this experiment in your home, because this is very simple and you will enjoy it. So in the next class, we'll discuss the next separation method, that is separation of two miscible liquids by the method of distillation. So that's all for today. Thank you.